I will be showing a certain number of examples in which project work inside a company. Secondly, projects can mean many different things. So we will try to establish a typology of project and to have what I call project profiles. And finally, I will compare project and operations. So what about projects in business? What you have here is the typical organizational chart of a company. So you have the management of the company, which cares about, for example, the strategy of the company. And then you have a series of divisions, for example, factories. And inside these divisions, you have work teams. Where are the projects in this organization? First case, you can have a small local project, which only concerns a work team. Then the project can concern the management as well. So for example, when you want to buy another company or to make something on the stock exchange, it only concerns the management of the company. But you have other kind of project. For example, in some cases, the teams must work together. Or sometimes a project can involve both the management of the company and one of the divisions. So this is called a transversal project. And of course, this project can be located and between different branches of the company. Now you have another case in which the project is fully out of the company organizational chart. So we'll be talking about that in detail. The principle there is to have a lot of autonomy in the project, so you have a dedicated team. The last case is when you have two companies working together. And in this case, you have a joint venture, and the project is done in common with two separate organizations. So this is the case of a joint venture. Now, let's get on to a typology of project. So what I'm showing you there is a measure of the complexity and the size of a project. So how do you measure the size of a project? Well, it's pretty easy. The bigger a project is, the more it costs. So this axis could be an axis with the amount of resources which are consumed by the project, or simply the budgeting. So here you have low complexity and small size. So we can talk about small local project. Case number two, if you want to have a reorganization, the reorganization can be small in size, but as you need to reallocate the way in which people work, there is a reorganization and it becomes more complex. By contrast, a thing which wouldn't please engineers, you can say that research and development project can be costly, but are low complexity. So the question now is to understand what complexity is. So let's get on to the last case. For example, you want to build a new factory in a country in which your company didn't work before. The project will be costly, but it will be very complex. Why? Because complexity doesn't come with technical, so a project can be can encompass a lot of technology, but this does not make automatically the project complex. What makes a project complex is the fact that you have a lot of different things to work with. For example, if you want to build a new factory, you have to think about legal matters in the new country. you have to hire people, you have to procure energy and electricity for the factory, you have to deal with local politicians. And all this turns your project into something very complex. So you see, complexity and size are different, and complexity is like the number of moving pieces you have to coordinate. Last thing is to understand more closely what a project profile is. In the first chapter, I have shown you that project can be very different things. So let's look at some of the characteristics they have. So we've seen that project size can vary, so you can have a small project or a big project, which is measured by the budget. You can look as well at the stakes or the importance of the project. What are the consequences if the project fails? You can look at the deliverables. Are the deliverables material or are they immaterial? For example, changing an organization. You can look at project complexity. You can look at how much a project is innovating. You can distinguish between project in which the team has a lot of autonomy and the project in which the team is already included within the organizational chart. So this is the integration within the organization. So the idea in project profile is to try to think, you think on each project you have in mind, and you try to draw the project profile. And you better understand what the characteristics of these precise projects are. Let's get on to some examples. Here we have a project which is about getting a certification for quality of the product which are manufactured in a factory. So in this case, the project will be either of small or medium size. The stakes are very high because if you do not have the quality certification, you will lose your customers. Deliverables are both immaterial and material. For example, you change working procedure, this is immaterials, and you have also to put in place new machines. And then you get on and you characterize the profile of your project. So for example, there you have a project team with a lot of autonomy. Another example now, what about improving the productivity in a business? So in this case, you would draw a new profile, for example, with a small size project. Stakes are pretty low, which means that even if the project is a partial success, it won't be a catastrophe. It can be of high complexity with few innovations, and the organization is constructed around the project. So you see, when you talk about project, you can think about drawing the project profile to have a better understanding of what your project is exactly. So now let's get on to other approaches for analyzing a project. You can use, for example, five questions. So the five W's: who, what, where, and why, when and why. Another methods we can use is strategic analysis. Strategic analysis is a way in which you understand, you try to analyze and to anticipate the position of the different actors in this project. Are they going to oppose the project or are they going to help it? So now let's get on to the next chapter, in which I will compare projects and operations.